Hello and welcome to Monmouth in Focus, a program about the services and functions of Monmouth County government. I'm Cynthia Scott, your host for this segment of Monmouth in Focus. And today we are joined by Nancy Frank, who is the director of the Victim Witness Unit at the Monmouth County Prosecutor's Office. Thanks so much for joining us today, Nancy. Pleasure to have you here on Monmouth in Focus.
Thank you for having me.
Tell us, what exactly is the Victims Witness Unit at the Prosecutor's Office?
So the Victim Witness Unit was established over 30 years ago, and it was to ensure that crime victims' rights would be held to the same standard as the defendant's rights. And so there was a movement years ago, and they established the state office. And with the state office, they have local county coordinators that oversee each and every county. They work within the Monmouth County Prosecutor's Office, and they work with the prosecutors and the detectives in the local municipalities to ensure that victims' rights are effective.
Right, and we're talking here in April because it's a special month for victims' rights. Tell us about that and why.
Okay, so, April marks the National Crime Victims' Rights, and so for the week of April 19th to the 25th, they will be celebrating victims' rights. And so the state office will be having their own special celebration in Trenton on Wednesday the 21st. Mm-hmm. And it's a great time to get together. This year's theme is engaging communities and empowering victims.
Okay, and so how do you do that? How do you engage communities and empower victims? I'm sure it's somewhat of a challenge, correct?
It can be. Yeah. We've been working with each and every single local police department. Our goal this year is to reach out to every single police department within Monmouth County personally and to readdress victims' issues and rights and changes that have been made and some upgrades that have taken place over the years. And so to retrain the officers and to remind them and work together.
And how does the prosecutor's office specifically support crime victims?
So we have a unit within our office, and with that unit we have 10 employees. We have some clerical staff, and we have 6 advocates. The advocates are specially trained in crisis intervention. They are also specially trained in certain areas, working with victims of domestic violence, working with grief, with homicide survivor families. And we also have a family juvenile justice advocate and a domestic violence, sexual assault.
Nancy, in your experience, how important is it for these victims to have rights? Because sometimes it's so difficult for them to express themselves and to trust people again and to really, you know, become a part of the community again sometimes.
It is so important. We really emphasize bridging the gap between the police, law enforcement, and the prosecutor's office. We really want to support the victims throughout the criminal justice process and to reduce the intimidation of the process, to reduce any inconveniences associated with the process, and to make them feel more comfortable. It is a lot of anxiety that they have already experienced due to the crime itself, and anything that we can do to make them more comfortable, to make them feel that there's somebody on their side, to have a special place in our courthouse where they can sit down and relax and be in a private space while they're waiting for court instead of in the hallways. And we want to make sure that they feel less intimidated walking into the courthouse. We want them to know that there's an advocate standing on the other side of the door waiting for them. Right. And we work really well with the sheriff's department. The sheriff's officers are always willing to help escort the victims in and out of the courthouse should they feel intimidated. They assist us with in and out of the courtrooms and making sure that they feel secure.
Right, absolutely, so important. And what other specific services does the victim have with the prosecutor's office?
That's a good question. So right from the very beginning, we work with the victims in letting them know the status of the case. We want to let them know that we're there. We want them to know what their rights are. We want them to know that we're going to notify them of every stage of the case. And that is from administrative decisions that are made in the office to grand jury preparation, to trial, to preparing for motions and sentencing and giving impact statements. We also want to make sure that they understand that there are certain services available. We refer victims to different counselors for special needs. We also work with them as far as Victims' Crime Compensation Office is concerned. We help them understand that there's an application that they may be eligible for, and we assist them with that process.
Right, and I would imagine that you have to help get the word out to the communities as well, you know, local agencies that might also be able to provide services to the victims, correct?
Yes, yes. We work really well with the Monmouth County Board of Mental Health. We work with 180, Turning Lives Around. We have people that are in the courthouse that we work directly with. We work with the Child Advocacy Center within our own office. Mm-hmm. We attend regular multidisciplinary meetings, team meetings. We domestic violence working group. And so we're working with the DCPMP and making sure that everybody is working together and constantly communicating and educating each other about each other's programs.
What could be the biggest challenge that you face or that your department faces when working with the victims? Some of them might not want to get involved because they're afraid. So is that a big challenge?
It is. There are people that are very afraid, and there are certain circumstances where relocation may be necessary. We do help people under those circumstances. Through the Victims of Crime Compensation, they have a program for that. We also try to help them reduce their fears about most of the victims of the crime really are not going to be stalked or tracked the way that they normally think that they will be. The accusers normally don't blame the victim. And when it's a domestic situation, there's a lot of resources available to them to help them through that process. Mm-hmm. And we work with them, and we make sure that they're in touch with them, and we work very carefully with them.
Nancy, how did you get involved in the unit?
Oh, so I worked as an intern when I was attending Rutgers University as an undergrad, and I was fortunate enough to work in the unit as an intern for the whole summer. I loved it, and it changed my path. Mm. I decided from there I wanted to become a paralegal, because at the time we did not have victim advocates under that title, so we were hired as paralegals. I went to Fairleigh Dickinson and I became a paralegal, and I re-entered the office as a paralegal, starting out in the victim witness unit.
Wow.
And so from there I worked on different trial teams, investigating all different cases, from terroristic threats to homicides, robberies and kidnappings and domestic violence. And I worked in our computer crimes unit in the investigative section. And then this position became available, and I was really happy to return to the unit.
Great.
Thank you.
You've seen a lot.
Yeah.
All right, Nancy, thanks so much for a job well done. And again, the week for National Crime Victims' Rights is April 21st?
It's April 19th. Through the 25th.
Through the 25th.
Yes.
Okay. And for more information, you can, of course, log on to www.visitmonmouth.com. That's all the time we have for this segment of Monmouth in Focus. Have a great day, everyone.